Good morning, my dear students of class 12. Today I will continue the chapter Reproductive Health. And today's topic is Sexually Transmitted Infections or Sexually Transmitted Diseases. So first we have to know what is the sexually transmitted infections. That means infections or diseases that are transmitted through the sexual intercourse. So I am repeating, infections or diseases which are transmitted through the sexual intercourse is called as sexually transmitted infections, or you can call it sexually transmitted diseases, or it is having an alternative name which is called as venereal diseases. Okay, alternative name of it is venereal diseases, or in short VD. So sexually transmitted infection is written in short like that. Sexually STIs, venereal disease, is written as VD, and you can call it sexually transmitted diseases. So STD. So when a disease can be transmitted through sexual intercourse, that is called a sexually transmitted disease. What are the examples of the sexually transmitted? Mainly, these sexually transmitted diseases can be of three types. Okay, that STD may be of bacterial, it may be viral, or protozoan. Okay, so STD may be bacterial or viral or protozoan. So first we will talk about the bacterial diseases or bacterial sexually transmitted diseases. So what are the examples? Examples are syphilis, gonorrhea, chlamydiasis. So these are the examples of bacterial disease. And what is the example of protozoan disease? Trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis is the example of protozoan STD. And what are the viral? AIDS, hepatitis B, herpes, genital warts. So these are the different types of sexually transmitted diseases. So I will talk one by one. First I will talk about the syphilis. So syphilis is a, wait a minute. So first I will talk about the syphilis. So syphilis is a, first syphilis is a, who is the causative organ bacteria in syphilis is Treponema pallidum. So I am rubbing that part. We will talk about the different causative organism of the all the diseases and the symptoms of all the diseases. So first one is syphilis. And who is the causative organism of syphilis is Treponema pallidum. That bacteria can cause syphilis, and it is a spirochete mainly. And what are the symptoms of this disease? What are the symptoms? Skin lesions. Okay, on the, and flat wart-like lesions on the skin through the body. So skin lesions at the site of infection and external genitalia. Flat wart-like lesions on the skin throughout the body, and it spreads to all the parts and affects nervous system when some granular lesions appear. Okay, and which can lead to paralysis. So these are the different symptoms of syphilis. So I am repeating, skin lesions, flat wart-like lesions on the skin and the external genital part, and in the severe case it may cause paralysis. So this is about first bacterial disease, syphilis. Next one is gonorrhea. सो नेक्स्ट बैक्टीरियल डिजीज इज गोनोरिया. And what is the positive organism of gonorrhea? Neisseria gonorrhoeae. That is the positive organism of gonorrhea. So what is the symptoms of that Neisseria gonorrhoeae or gonorrhea disease? So in case of males, a watery discharge followed by thick white fluid from the penis. Okay, so in case of males, a watery fluid like discharge from the penis can be seen, and a painful sensation at the time of urination also be seen. Okay, and sterility may result due to blockage of epididymis. In male, sterility may result due to blockage of the epididymis. And these are the symptoms found in case of males. And what are the symptoms can be found in case of females? Sterility may result, burning sensation while urination, inflammation of the epithelial cervix and urethra. Okay, corneal infection can also occur. So these are the different symptoms of gonorrhea in case of males and females. What is the next? Next one is chlamydiasis. Chlamydiasis, and causative organism is Chlamydia trachomatis. So next bacterial disease is chlamydiasis, and causative organism is Chlamydia trachomatis. That is the scientific name. That's why I'm writing like that. Chlamydia trachomatis. And what are the symptoms of this disease? That sometimes fever and nausea, abdominal pain, and bleeding between the menstruation, abnormal vaginal discharge, burning sensation while urination. Okay, so what are the symptoms of this? Abdominal pain, bleeding, abnormal bleeding in between the menstruation, vaginal discharge. Okay, so these are the different symptoms of chlamydiasis. So this is all about the different bacterial sexually transmitted disease. Next one, I will talk about the disease which can be caused by protozoa. That was trichomoniasis, and its causative organism is Trichomonas vaginalis. The causative organism of trichomoniasis is Trichomonas vaginalis. That is an example of protozoa. That protozoa can cause the trichomoniasis disease. And what are the symptoms? Itching and irritation of genital organs, burning sensation while urinating, and yellow foamy discharge from the vagina with a odor. Okay, so yellow foamy discharge from the vagina with a odor, urine painful sensation at the time of urination, and itching and irritation in the genital organs. These are the common symptoms of trichomoniasis. Next is viral diseases. What are the different viral diseases? First one is AIDS. What is the full form of AIDS? Acquired immunodeficiency. So, what is the full form? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome is called as, in short, AIDS. Okay, and it can be caused by a virus which is called as HIV virus, human immunodeficiency virus. दिस एड्स कैन बी कॉज्ड बाय अ वायरस विच इज कॉल्ड एज HIV वायरस और इन फुल ह्यूमन इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी वायरस एंड हाउ इट स्प्रेड्स इट स्प्रेड्स विद द सेक्सुअल इंटरकोर्स दैट मीन्स इफ अ पर्सन हैविंग एड्स एंड विद अनप्रोटेक्टेड सेक्स बाय द अनप्रोटेक्टेड सेक्स विद द पर्सन एड्स कैन बी स्प्रेड एंड अगेन अनदर इज द विद द सीरिंज नीडल्स ओके ब्लेड्स दिस डिजीजेस कैन बी स्प्रेड बिकॉज ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ ब्लड एंड ब्लड प्रोडक्ट If they are contaminated with HIV, then this disease can be spread through this. Okay? So, that's why use of sterilization needles and syringes is better to use. Okay? So, what are the symptoms of this HIV AIDS? So, symptoms are nymphoids, fever, loss of weight, and very low immunity. These are the different symptoms of AIDS. Okay, that means this virus actually attacks the helper T cells and hence the their number is decreases and the immune system of the patient gets weaker as they are attacking the helper T cell by which their number decreases and their immune system of that person is quite weaker. Okay, or weaker and the person becomes prone to any kind of infection. Thus, person become prone to any kind of infections. Okay? So, these are the different ways by which AIDS can be transmitted and these are the different symptoms. Next one is hepatitis B. Next viral disease of hepatitis B and it can be caused by hepatitis B virus. It also spreads in the same way like AIDS. The spreading of the hepatitis B is the quite same with the spreading of AIDS. And what are the symptoms? Mild fever, nausea or vomiting, skins or cornea sometimes become yellow, loss of appetite, dark yellow colored urine. Okay, and ultimately in that case the liver will be damaged. These were the some general or common symptoms but ultimately they will affect the liver and the liver will be damaged. Okay, so that is and the vaccines for hepatitis B has been produced by the recombinant DNA technology and it is used for this preventive purpose. But there is no vaccine for the AIDS. That's why we can control that part. But the vaccine of hepatitis B is available. Next one is genital herpes or genital herpes. So, next viral disease is herpes and it is caused by herpes simplex virus. And what are the symptoms of this disease? That small blisters or open sores on the penis or vagina, vaginal discharge, itching, burning sensation. Okay, swollen glands in the genital area. These are the symptoms of herpes. I am repeating that itching, burning sensation, small blisters or open sores in the penis or vagina, vaginal discharge, swollen glands in the genital area. These are the symptoms of herpes. So next and last one is genital or genital warts. Next one is genital warts. It is caused by a virus which is called as human human papilloma virus. PAPILLOMA, human papilloma virus. It is caused by human papilloma virus. And what are the symptoms of this disease? The symptoms are that some flat warts like structures can be found in the genital area. and lesions in the vagina and cervix. Okay, and it can cause a cancer in the cervix, which is called as cervical cancer. Okay, it can cause the cervical cancer, and this disease also can be treated through the reduce this severity, but there is no cure for the disease right now. Okay, there is still now there is no proper cure of this disease. So mainly word like structures will be found in that case. Okay, so these are the different types of bacterial, protozoal and viral diseases or sexually transmitted diseases. Now if I say what are the general symptoms of STDs, if I ask you what are the general symptoms of STDs, what you will say? That there are some general symptoms which include itching. If I say itching, fluid discharge, and what are the another pain or swellings in the abdominal region. Sorry, genital organ swellings in the genital region, or pain in the genital region, pain or swellings in the genital region, abdominal pain, nausea, fever. Okay, so itching, fluid discharge, slight pain or swelling in the genital area, these are the in that case some major and minor symptoms will be there. Okay, so these are the some symptoms can be found, and there are so many other symptoms, like I have explained that abdominal pain, burning sensation at the time of urination, but genital warts like structures, lymph glands will be swollen. Okay, these are the symptoms of STDs or vaginal discharge. Okay, there are so many general symptoms of STDs. Now we can say that what are the if these STDs will be treated, then it can be controlled somewhat. But if it is untreated, what complications may come? That means that time that infertility, stillbirths, cancers, okay, abortions, these complications may come if it is not treated or it is untreated. So what are they? Infertility, abortions, stillbirths, cancers. Okay, now if I ask you what are the preventions of STDs, so what will be the prevention of STDs? So first one is avoid sex with multiple partners. Avoid sex with multiple partners is first one prevention, or you can say that multiple or unknown partner. And always try to use condoms at the time of sexual intercourse. As I have told that condom is a barrier method, and it is very useful not only for the conception, it also preventing the couple from spreading the sexually transmitted diseases or sexually transmitted infections. Okay, so use of condom, that's why is very popular nowadays. Next one is that if in case of doubt, one should go to a qualified doctor, and for early detection and get complete treatment if diagnosed with infection. So detection and treatment, detection and treatment. How? With consultation ऑफ डॉक्टर्स. So how these sexually transmitted diseases can be prevented by the avoiding sex with the multiple partners or unknown partners, and always you have to use the condom for not to spreading that STDs or STIs or VDs, and the early detection is required by the detection and proper treatment the STD can be prevented. So these are all about sexually transmitted diseases symptoms and their different preventions. So in my next class I will talk about the infertility. Only infertility part from this chapter is left. So in my next class I will explain the infertility part. Today the total sexually transmitted diseases or STI part I have completed. So for today that's it, and thank you.